These are the 7 stupid things you've got to have in your golf bag. Now, listen to me right here. We all know we need 14 clubs, we need some gloves in there, golf balls, markers. We know we need all that stuff. But these are 7 things that you won't have thought of, and I actually had these in the bag every single time I went out on the golf course when I used to caddy on the European Tour. Few of them saved my feet and definitely stopped me getting in a lot of pain. Well, I did it once and then didn't do it again. Anyway, let's get into this video. And by the way, at any point, get down in those comments and let me know if I've missed anything off. Is there anything that you have in your golf bag which would potentially help some others? Get down in those comments. I want to hear the most stupid thing that you've got in your bag. Okay, first things first. I'm going to go with a resealable bag. So these are like those resealable bags you might put like your lunch in on your work. Those ones like those little zip ties. I know it might sound silly, but bear with me. Now, the reason why I would do this, like, I honestly hate wearing rain gloves. Tom used to hate wearing rain gloves. I think they are the worst thing ever. It just feels like clunky on your hands. So, what we did was, we put, anytime we finished with a glove and it was becoming an old one, put it in this resealable bag, and then we could just whip them out. They would stay nice and dry, whip them out of the resealable bag. If it rained on the bag, they didn't get wet, they didn't get damaged, and you also save a little bit of money. So, first things first, resealable bag. Forget putting your sarnies in it. Golf gloves are more important, especially if you're using those leather ones. Like, I can't tell you how much I hate rain gloves. Okay, next up, plasters and tape. I can't believe, well, I'll say I was the same. I'm saying this in hindsight now because I can't believe people don't carry it. So let me just give you a little bit of a story. I was caddying for Tom in La Cala, and if anybody's been there, get down in the comments because that place is so, so hilly. I had the worst blisters known to man. Honestly, my feet were in bits. I wish I had plasters. Since that day, I will never not go on the golf course without plasters. I had a brand new pair of shoes on and they tore my feet a bit. Like, I bet there's so many out there that have had that same situation. So you can also pop them in that little resealable bag, stop them getting wet. So either like tape for your fingers or plasters for those heels, absolutely essential. Number 3 in our list is face sun cream and lip balm. Whew. Lips. There's no worse thing, right? Coming off the golf course, feeling like this, and your lips are an absolute mess. Just look like Belisha Beacons. So 100%. Also, it's going to protect your skin. I pop it on my ears, on my cheeks, and I even, might sound strange, but I even pop it on when I go coaching now, right? Because, like, if you're out the golf course for 3 to 4 hours, definitely want to have that bit of protection on there. Okay, we're 3 in here. Is there anything that I have missed off so far that you have in your golf bag? If you've not put it down in the comments, do so. And also, subscribe to the channel. Hit the bell and never miss a video here on Back 9 Films. Next up, this is key. Written yardages. Now, you might not know how far your golf clubs go, all of them, that is, but you might know how far your 7-iron goes. That tends to be the club that I would use the most at the range, or you would use the most at the range. So, what I would do is, I would have a little piece of paper, just a scrap piece of paper, or, if you want, get a little bit of a notebook. Write down how far your 7-iron goes, and then, roughly, add 10 yards up to your 6-iron, take 10 yards off to your 8-iron, and as you move down or up a club, just add or take away 10 yards. This way you're going to have a little bit of a rough guide on how far your golf ball is going, because this is actually essential to help lower your scores. Because if you think about it, and this is how I would paint the picture, imagine an island green, and hopefully we get to play a lot of them this year on the channel, and you might have one at your golf course where it's got surrounded by bunkers or surrounded by water, where you've got to know how far you've got to hit it. There's no worse feeling than buttoning a shot and it not getting there, or flying the green and it going in the water. So just having a little bit of a guide on how far your clubs go is absolutely essential to lowering your scores. Like, this on the screen now is a little bit of an example of how I do mine. Yes, it looked a little bit tatty, I know, but it's just something just to go, ah, boom. That's how far it goes. You don't second guess yourself. Okay, next on our list, your wrench. So most of us now, whether you're looking at Cobra drivers, Taylormade, Callaway, Ping, PXG. What driver are you using, by the way? Let me know if I missed one off there. They're all adjustable. And sometimes, if we have adjusted it, say, in a rain session and we've changed our loft, we might not have tightened it properly. Now, if that head becomes a little bit loose, as far as I'm aware, you are allowed to then tighten the head. You're not allowed then to change the loft, but you can re-tighten the head. There's no worse feeling, right? Imagine getting down the first hole, ripping one down the first, ripping one down the second, thinking, hoo-hoo, that new loft of my driver is absolutely sorting me out. And then get into the next hole and realize it's a little bit loose. You'll be scared of that head flying down the golf course. And believe me, I have seen that. So just carry your wrench in your bag. You can then just give it a little bit of a test. I would even tighten it on the first hole before you even peg it up, just to do a make sure. And then you've just got it there as a little bit of a backup, which is key. Number six on our list, your Sharpie. Now, I know a lot of us think, yes, I carry a Sharpie. And what color do you carry? I carry blue. Blue only. But one thing I would have with this all the time is that little bit of a template. I like to put a little bit of a cross section on my golf ball, and this just gives me a chance of going, okay, if I've lost too many golf balls today and I've been ball hunting, whip a new ball out, line it up. Because think about it, you line your ball up on the first, but you might have lost two or three, and then you might not have one lined up. So just having them readily at hand is 100% the thing you've got to do. This is a must for me. I get hangry. 100% get hangry. I get miserable when I'm not eating. I don't know if you feel the same. So what I do is 100% keep a little bit of a snack bottom of the bag. This is not a paid ad. This is my favorite snack. A little bit of saurine, chunky. And yes, I do consume a whole loaf in one round usually. But having them more on the bottom of the bag, just something to eat when you're out on the golf course. Because coming down those last few holes, you want to be having your best concentration. You want to be feeling your best to complete a decent score, whether it's breaking 100, breaking 90, breaking 80, just keep a snack in your bag, because guaranteed, right, if you get up on a Saturday morning, had a few beers the night before, that bacon butty halfway around, yeah, it might sort you out, but that is not going to last all the way to the 18th. So having a little bit more in there just to keep you going is 100% the way you've got to go. Guys, thanks so much for watching. If I have missed anything on this list, do not forget to get down in these comments, and you know what, please do subscribe. Thanks.